Well, you know, it's obvious the cupboard wasn't bare when he took that job at Maryland. Some players.
But he changed their psyche.
Yep.
Changed their outlook. Gave them some discipline. Gave them an offense and a defense that they could work within.
Third quarter is over. 31-21 Stanford by 10 after three. An ABC Sports presentation of college football returns after this message and a word from our ABC stations. On the 25-yard line, ball possessed by Stanford as we start the final period of play. Second down and eight. Chris Lewis, brilliant in the first half. Very quiet here in the second half. They stay with the ground game, and they pound it up the middle, and there just is nothing there right now. Kerry Carter, the big guy.
Score by quarters, obviously. Stanford got after that big halftime lead. And UCLA with a fairly successful third quarter, and that's with Corey Paws out of the ball game. Scott McEwen comes in and throws the touchdown pass, and Deshaun Foster got a touchdown.
Third down and six for Stanford. They need a first down. They need something to get their machine rolling. They're not going to run it down the pipe. Lewis's pass incomplete. Penalty flag. Theo Johnson, the target, covered by Joe Hunter. And they threw the flag immediately.
You can't run through a guy to the football. I mean, that football is as much yours as it is the offensive guy. But the big Theo Johnson has great position on Hunter. And so Hunter tries to go over him and through his head to get to the football. That's pass interference. You cannot do that. And again, Lewis just put it out there where his guy could go and run and get it. Lewis playing a magnificent football game. How about the numbers for Chris Lewis today? 15 of 22, 213 yards.
And he's leading by 10 here in the fourth quarter of play.
Hunter, if he's going to make that stop against a bigger defender, he's got to use the sideline and play him inside out. He tried to come from behind. Just poor positioning. That's what Phil Snow's telling him now.
They're going to put the ball finally, put it down at the 37-yard line, and that's where it'll be first down for Stanford. Back to Carter.
See, the pass interference gives them a first down. And the more first down Stanford can get right now, the more in control of the ball game they are. As we go under 14 minutes, time becomes a factor for UCLA. Still 10 points down. And the offense is in absolutely no hurry and shouldn't be. And Lewis is doing a great job minding the clock. Just take your time inside. Let the clock continue to roll. Get the team in and out effectively.
Never take a snap until you're inside 10 seconds. You got 15 on it, 14, 13. He's calling his cadence, though, and he's going to take it pretty quickly. Takes the snap on 7 seconds. Little quick pop out here to Casey Moore. Moore with a straight arm will pick up a couple of yards because of that. And the ball will come out to about the 44-yard line.
Two starting quarterbacks out of the game. Randy Fasani hurt last week. Corey Paws hurt his hand in the first half here. So you bring in Scott McEwen. He's 8 for 14. And look at the game that Lewis is having for Stanford. 16 of 23, 218 yards, 3 touchdowns. He did have that pick, but a marvelous game by Lewis.
Could have been sacked right there. Gets his pass away, and it's dropped. He held it. He had it by his fingertips and went to the ground with it.
You won't believe this. Saved. He caught it with his knees.
Saved it.
I'm not kidding you.
He got a first down.
Brett Pierce lost it in his hands and caught it in his legs. This is the escapability we talked about at the beginning of the game. It looked like he was sacked, uses some strength. Then he throws a good pass to Pierce. Now watch Pierce's acrobatic move here. Whoops, whoops. Get it in his knees. Keep it right there in his legs. Now bring it back up with your hands. Not everybody can make that catch.
If you want to save that for your grandchildren, but it worked. Lewis goes down all the way back on the 40-yard line. Brandon Chiller is the man that made the tackle.
Boy, and I will tell you, Chiller just ran over Casey Moore.
That is UCLA's first sack today.
Here's number 11. Watch the collision with 33 Casey Moore, and he drives him right back. Moore loses that battle, and Chiller gets the sack. And you know, it's something that UCLA's been able to do today is to get after Chris. They hit him 11 times, sacked him once, hurried him 9 times, and forced one turnover. But the kid's calm and collected and very poised.
Second down and 19. Lost 9 yards. Dumps it off. Got a little screen action going with Terry Carter. Carter's back across midfield. And back to the original line of scrimmage almost. It's going to be about 11 yards to go on third down. At the conclusion of today's game, Chevrolet player of the game will be chosen from each team. Chevrolet making a $1,000 contribution to each university general scholarship fund.
Boy, Eric Heitman just crushed Marcus Anderson on that block, and that's why that play worked as well as it did. Got back to the original line of scrimmage.
Third down. Lewis passes away. Threw it right to Anderson. And Anderson is back to the 37-yard line, 38, for its first down, UCLA.
That is a young mistake by Chris Lewis. He's just a sophomore, doesn't have a whole lot of playing experience. This is a ball that should not have been thrown. The last thing you want here is a turnover. You've got good field position. Even if you don't score, you can back UCLA up. But here, he's got time. He never looks off his receiver. He throws into coverage, and the only one there is Marcus Anderson. He was trying to get it to Johnson, but Anderson turns on him and makes a good play from the safety spot. Right there, and his 10 buddies out on the field. Defensively, Stanford wasn't tested that much in the first half. The offense did a great job. You see time of possession. The defense wasn't on the field that much. Right now, Stanford has to come up with a stop here against UCLA, or they're going to be in a world of trouble here late in the fourth.
McEwen comes underneath with it, completes the pass to Fletcher, the tight end. And they've got him out of bounds somewhere around the 47-yard line on the Stanford side of the field. Rather than get greedy deep, he took the short man that was open.
Well, and the Bruins are starting to figure this thing out. They're starting to dink and dunk, go to high percentage passes. They are still taking their shots deep, as we saw them go to Ryan Smith. We saw them try to get to Tab Perry deep. That eventually is going to open things up for Deshaun Foster. We saw some of that in the third period as well. But they're starting to use this defense and put it on its heels a little bit.
First down on the play.
Here's Deshaun Foster, bottom of the screen.
Yes! Sacked him. Ball loose. Stanford got it. Anthony Gabriel, his third big play of the day. Austin Lee, the big tackle, covered it.
Defense needed a big play. The onus was on them, and the Cardinal comes through. Top of the screen, here's your linebacker coming backside. As soon as McEwen pumps, that's when he has a chance to jump him. The ball thrown there, no problem. But since he holds on to it, Gabriel comes hard from the backside and gets the sack. Here's Deshaun Foster, the hitch, the go. If he had time, they had a touchdown. But instead, Gabriel makes the big play defensively. So the Cardinal finally tested, and they passed that test with flying colors.
First down, UCLA 47-yard line. That's Ryan Allen. 3 yards.
Not the prettiest game today. 4 turnovers, both teams. Boy, that was a huge play.
Give Allen 4, call it second down 6. The ball resting at the 43-yard line. Lewis wants to throw, goes underneath, down the middle with it. Pass complete to Ryan Wells. Wells dropped at the 38-yard line. He needs about a yard and a half for a first down, and Marcus Anderson the hit. Washington State, UCLA, the only undefeated team starting this day in the Pac-10.
You know, what's really impressive about Lewis is the fact he doesn't get shaken. He makes a mistake, and he comes right back and makes some very good decisions.
Third down and 2. Big play here for Stanford. They go to Carter. He's got the first down.
Carter's had a good day. Big 235-pound running back. Well, I'm saying he's got it. It may be require further study.
Boy, Allen, the small, quick guy. Carter, the banger. Look at the power he has here when he hits and explodes. He gets through pretty quickly, too, for a 6'2", 235-pounder.
Change coming in. I think he has.
He should have it. Yeah, that's a. It's. Oh, he's a little bit short.
He is short.
Now, do you go for it?
Yep.
If I'm Ty Willingham, I do.
Yep.
And I keep it in the hands of Lewis. You're in four down territory. This is a team that has a reputation of going for it on fourth down anytime they cross midfield.
All of their power and experience and size is right there in the middle. Three seniors, two guards in the center.
They may hand it off, but I wouldn't. Second effort, but I'll tell you, Thomas made an unbelievable play. And
timed
Lewis
just right.
Lewis took the hit and got the first on second effort, I believe.
Watch the hit by Thomas.
Boy, you talk about a collision and guessing right. Here he is right here, and he's coming hard, and he knows where the ball's going to be. Now watch the collision, and then watch the second effort by Lewis. Takes the hit, bounces off. And actually, the push from behind by Ryan Neese helped him along to get the first. Terrific play by the sophomore.
36-yard line, UCLA side of the ball, and it's first down Stanford, and they desperately needed it. This is Carter, and he's going to lose a yard on the play as UCLA again came hard. Second down, 11 for Stanford. Williams got caught on the, in the no man land, and that'll cost him 5 yards. The attendance today is 64,495. Biggest crowd they've had this year at Stanford. Second down and six. Lewis gives to Allen. Not much. Maybe a yard. The Cardinal with only one loss, that to Washington State, here at the farm. Bruins coming into town undefeated. Stanford trying to put a loss on them, having put a loss on Oregon last week. And if Oregon does the same thing to Washington State today, then you have just got everybody back in the hunt, practically in the Pac-10. The Huskies are back in it, certainly.
Those numbers are incredible.
Lewis to throw it. Has his man. Fumble. Bruins have it. Luke Powell hit by Marcus Anderson and somebody else, and the ball came out.
Anderson's dragging his shoulder, but I'll tell you this, that was a great lick, and Matt Ware was there as well. How he got open, they were in zone coverage and worked his way to the seam. That's how he got there. And Lewis delivered on time. But here comes the hit by Anderson. Ball's loose. People are scrambling. Here comes Matt Ware. And the UCLA Bruins have another turnover. But Lewis put it right where he had to. That's just a fantastic hit by the safety, Marcus Anderson.
Scott McEwen back. Throws underneath. Sets up screen for Deshaun Foster. Got one block. Got another block. And he's all the way out across the 40-yard line to the 41.
Saying sure, picked up a lot of yardage here, but he could have picked up more. Look how they set up this screen, and look at his convoy in front of him with these blockers here and then up here with Mike Seidman. If he just waits, let these guys develop, cut back in, nicely done. Now wait for some of these other blockers to come down, like number 78 Bolander and 76 Vieira.
That's out of bounds, incomplete.
Tank Williams, as good as it gets back there. A couple of great safeties playing in this ball game with Anderson and Tank Williams.
And that ball off, a little old Statue of Liberty kind of action as Mark Deshaun Foster took the ball from McEwen, and he picks up about 2 yards on the play.
Great play by Tank.
Third down and eight.
Scott McEwen swings it outside. Pass is caught by the fullback. And he's going to have a first down. First down from the 46. McEwen's pass to the sidelines is good. Ryan Smith. McEwen showing a good arm. Same combination. This one does not work. Second down and 10 with 5:06 to play in the ball game. Ball on the UCLA 33. Looks and looks, has time. Now he's got a chance, but pulls it down and steps quickly out of bounds before Tank Williams can get a hold of him. Third and 5.
Here's your big play guy. That's Bragg.
Goes down the middle for the tight end. Touchdown, Brian Fletcher.
Two tight end situation. They flex Fletcher a little bit. He's on the right of the screen, out of the picture. But this is a great touch by McEwen. Puts a little air under it. Lets his tight end Fletcher run to it. And just over the hand of Hadari, who tried to knock it away. Perfectly thrown by McEwen.
It'd be something that was said, too.
And this is a huge point, because this pulls it within a field goal.
It's a 35-yard point after. Plenty of leg. Good. 3-point ball game. UCLA trailed 31-7 with 9:44 to go in the third quarter. And they're now within 3, 31-28. That young fellow walking around right there, if the Bruins pull this out, boy, is he going to get a seat at the head table at the postseason football dinner.
But you know what, partner, you're right, but there's still a lot of football left to be played here. Stanford still playing really well. And Lewis, wow, what a game.
Knuckleball is going to go well in the end zone beyond the field of play, and it'll come out to the 20-yard line where it'll be first down.
Here we go. This should be spectacular for the last 4:44 of the game. See the numbers on Chris Lewis. Just phenomenal. 20 of 28.
He hadn't done anything in quite a while. The running game hasn't done much either. And Chris is going to roll it out and look. Passes away, and it is intercepted. Intercepted! Matt Ware makes the interception.
And bracket him. This time, Matt Ware has him perfectly covered. Now watch. He buys time here, and he's got plenty of time to throw. Here's the bottom of your screen. Here's your coverage. Inside out, inside out. Read the ball, and now you become the receiver instead of the defender. That is great defense on Natchez by Ware.
39-yard line. The Bruins come with Deshaun Foster.
Pacific Life game summary. And these numbers are fairly indicative of how things have changed. McEwen came in for Paws, who was struggling a little bit. Paws was 5 of 16, and McEwen comes in and goes 13 for 21. Foster finds some life a little bit, scores a touchdown. Total yards, 415 for Stanford, but most of those were in the first half. And you see what Lewis has done, spectacular numbers.
Second down and 6. Brian Taylor is in the secondary for Stanford. Fumble! Stanford covers the ball. Big fight going on. UCLA might have gotten a hold of it as he rolled over it. It was Craig Albrecht that laid the hit on him. Ball came out. Stanford man rolled across the top of it. And UCLA saying they have it.
Oh, man, Albrecht.
And Gordon Reese agrees.
Albrecht almost killed McEwen. Looked like a big old grizzly bear coming up behind him. Here we're going to come right here. And he's coming in this way. Spins off. Now watch when he comes from behind. Actually, I had the wrong guy, but it was Albrecht 79. Looked like a big grizzly bear came behind him.
Yeah, if the Stanford man had just gone down on the ball and covered it, instead he, for some reason, tried to pick it up. He wanted to run with it, and as a result, he doesn't get it.
That could have been,
locked 6 points.
On. Katie barred the door is exactly right. Even if they got the ball, if he just fell on it.
Third down and 16. It was Austin Lee trying to pick it up and run with it. And it's third and 16 for UCLA at 3:45 to go. The ball is back on their own 33-yard line. The Bruins have 2 timeouts remaining.
Stanford defense trying to hold on. Passes away. Passes good. Pass the 40 to the 42 to Brian Fletcher. He caught the last touchdown pass for the Bruins. Scott McCune, senior out of Thousand Oaks, California, coming onto the second half after Corey Paws bruised a thumb on a helmet. Fourth and seven. Tab Perry coming over the middle. He's going deep with it. Too far. Lewis gives it to Carter. Carter bangs over the right side, gets 3 yards. The Pac-10 standings as we started the day today. UCLA struggling here, trying to pull one out against the home team. Washington State waiting at home against the Oregon Ducks. By the end of the day, who knows if anybody is standing.
If UCLA does get the ball back, Ryan Fernandez, we're told, will not be back. Strained knee, so Brian Taylor will have to step in. But you have the feeling now to take a miracle for UCLA.
Second down and six. Able to run. That's Carter spinning. And the big guy is going to be very, very close to a first down. He's hard to handle. 235 pounds. And he came here from Ontario and has basically learned to play the game after he came to Stanford.
Got a flag down, face mask against UCLA.
Hale Johnson comes wide to the left, bottom of your picture. The big wide receiver. They give it back to the big back Carter. He breaks free. He's going to score. Now you can blow out the lights.
Great hold. Great blocking by the line. Missed tackle by Ben Emanuel, who's in for Jason Stevens. And Carter takes it and wraps this game up for Stanford.
Viselli for the extra point. Good. Even 2 minutes to play in the ball game. And the lead is again 10 for the Stanford Cardinal.
Experienced offensive line, three seniors. They average 303 pounds. They just zone block, block down, and just develop this hold. They're all going this way, this way, this way. Watch them all get blocks. Roll it, and there they go. Now he just searches for the opening. 24 comes over late. That's Ben Emanuel. Can't get the tackle, and Carter takes it in for the touchdown. Big, strong offensive line just bulldozed their way through there. And he was very patient, great eyesight to find the hole, pick the hole, and explode through it.
But some kind of a triple header today on ABC Sports. We started this morning at 9 o'clock Western time in Oklahoma, Nebraska. Now we've got this one. It's been a war. And coming up next, another one probably just like it. This is Akil Harris. And Harris with a good return up to the 27-yard line. Scott McEwen's been pretty good, too. The pass is thrown and the pass is completed. He was sandwiched between two Stanford defenders. I mean, just clobbered. And yet he delivered the ball to Craig Bragg for a catch. And the Bruins have done that today.
Watch how he gets sandwiched.
Bennett inside.
McEwen came in. Now he's shaken up. Now they go to Ryan McCann.
Well, Paws bruised thumb. They don't know about that for sure either, because he hammered it on a helmet. And a lot of bad things can happen to a thumb when you spike it on a helmet. And it's on his throwing hand. And now Scott McEwen comes off. He's walking a little better, but not a whole lot. And he had good numbers when he came off the field. He's the man that brought UCLA back into the ballgame. No question about it. And now here is Ryan McCann. And that's incomplete.
And the toughest thing for a quarterback that's just coming into the ball game is to feel the quickness. He's got to pick up the tempo a little bit.
Throws it underneath, throws it behind the Craig Bragg. Bragg can't pull it in, and the pass is incomplete. He takes off one. Now he's got to get rid of the ball, and he does. And he bounces it downfield toward one of his receivers, and that'll go as an incomplete forward pass. Fourth down for UCLA. The last gasp. Throw it as far as he can, and he's got a man downfield, and it's on his hands, and he can't hold it. It's Craig Bragg. And he had it on his hands, but it fell off as he was reaching for it. And Stanford gets the ball back on the UCLA side of the field.
Another unbeaten goes down today. What a day this has been for the BCS. Incredible. Oklahoma goes down. UCLA goes down. Virginia Tech goes down. And the BCS standings are going to take a dramatic change.
And Maryland is trailing now in that ball game.
Miami, all the folks down in Miami were concerned about the BCS standings, thinking they were getting a bad side of the deal again, and all of a sudden here they are right back in the thick of it. They'll move way up.
Miami, Nebraska, BYU, Washington State remain the unbeatens, and the Washington State's yet to play today. And the Cardinal now just going to run out the clock. Today's Chevrolet players of the game are Scott McEwen of UCLA, Chris Lewis of Stanford. Recognition of their efforts, Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. McEwen, 15 out of 24, 221 yards and two touchdowns. Chris Lewis, 20 out of 29, 250 yards, three touchdowns and three picks.
Here's a look at Randy Fasani. Wasn't able to play today. A lot of the Stanford fans are saying, man, we've got Fasani out, so we're handicapped. Lewis comes in, and Lewis has just an incredible day. He's so poised. He was calm all day, made some big passes, was sharp. Lewis ends the day 20 of 29, 250 yards, three touchdowns. You could not ask more of a young quarterback than Chris Lewis gave Stanford today. Spectacular job. Great effort by all the Cardinals.
Well, there's still some thumping going on, and you can hear the whacking all the way up here. The San Jose game is a makeup game from the cancellations that occurred in September. And then Notre Dame is on November 24. And Stanford still running the ball, killing the clock. 13 seconds, 12. UCLA's remaining games are Washington State, Oregon, USC, and Arizona State. For both teams rolling along in good seasons, but it is loss number one for the UCLA Bruins, as they're going to lose today to the Stanford Cardinal by a score of 38-28. And it's been a remarkable 2 weeks for Tyrone Willingham and his Stanford football team. Once again, our final score, UCLA 28, Stanford 38.